Welcome back. Good afternoon to Mark Cooper Challenge here on Nap Habit. Got a lot to get through, so I'm going to hurry up. So we're going to start with some apologies. Last week, a few too many sherbets. Forgot to do the Nailsworth Facebook update, which I know I enjoy at least. So Mel asked, did anybody hear a really strange animal sound around 4 a.m. on or near Star Hill? Vixen? Cats? Too low pitched, methinks. Rutting deer? Something nocturnal. Steve says, muntjac have a surprisingly loud bark. Mating foxes can make a lot of noise too. Rob says, foxes make a horrible screech when they're banging. Makes you want to change your crackers if you're all alone in the dark. Claire said, we have the same noise in Newmarket Valley. Anne says, I've heard a fox the last few mornings. Awful screaming. And I've seen a muntjac in next door's garden. Take your pick. Right, so that's other apology for me is I think I was getting far too waylaid flirting with other clubs, thinking about the future instead of concentrating on Forest Green's promotion push. So none of that today. Right, quick season review of League Two. Let's dib into the table as it ended. Get out of here. It's very slow, this. Carabao Cup. Chelsea won that one 5-0 at Wembley against Watford. FA Cup yet to be played between Chelsea and Arsenal. And here we are. So we finished, yes, in fifth place with 73 points. Luton Town winning the league. That's excellent. And if we get into League Two stats, we will see Pablo Fernandez, the Mark Cooper loan signing from Gijon, wins the Golden Boot. 19 goals in the regular league season. Christian Doige, two behind him on 17. Very impressive. Doige, though, 18 assists, a league high. Really great. And our goalkeeper, Collins, with 16 clean sheets. Right, so what has happened since that last game of the season is we've played our first leg, the away leg against Exeter in the playoffs. It was a 0-0 draw. We battered them in the first half. They had a go in the second half, but I don't think they got one on target. We had a penalty in the 89th minute. Pablo Fernandez went to the right, keeper went the right way, and kept it 0-0 for the game at New Lawn. So we're focusing today on Keanu Marsh-Brown. You'll have seen him playing right wing for us. Ooh, he's not looking too fit for this one. They're all looking a little tired, having just played the other leg. Where is he now? Down here, number 7. 64 rating, age 25, 6'1". Has that special something, apparently. An important player in a bit of form, very happy. Marsh-Brown in League 2, played 42 games, 5 goals, 5 assists. Great stuff. Attributes-wise, yeah, he's all about the 78 for pace. And he's got a bit of flair, as you can see from this great haircut icon. Finances wise, he's worth nearly £500,000, which is good for us. Let's just see. Where is he on the list? Yeah, he's up there. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The most valuable player. And he's on 5k a week, which I think has got to be, yeah, he's as well paid as anybody on our books. Him and Ruben Reed, Jesus. He's not played much, has he? Ruben Reed. No, just 21 appearances in all competitions. 4 goals, though, in League Two. Anyway, we're not looking at Ruben Reed today. We're looking at Keanu. So, let's get into it against Exeter. We need to win. I'm fairly confident that we will be going through. I think it was Wickham took the lead against Notts County in the other half of the draw. Obviously, we're in green at the New Lawn. That's not good for me, but that's not good for the colorblind community. But you've got your black shorts there. You can play green against red. Right, we're going to play, I've decided, we're going to start Charlie Cooper today. So, let's get Charlie Cooper in. Try and use a bit of his dribbling ability to penetrate the Exeter lines. They played 4-4-2 against us last time. Now, Keanu Marsh-Brown, oh yeah, he's a bit tired, but he'll have to stay with that. I think we're just going to have to go with a slightly tired 11 today. It's that stage of the season, isn't it? Bring Campbell in for a bit of pace on the wing, maybe. Yeah, let's bring him in for Grubb, actually. I like this Campbell kid. He's got a good raw power to him. Yeah, so Keanu Marsh-Brown was born in London. Had a youth career with Arsenal and Fulham. More so with Fulham. I watched an interview with him, between him and a Memphis-based reporter. More on that later. He says he played in the Europa League for Fulham. This is not mentioned on Wikipedia, Soccer Base, transfermarket.co.uk, or on a Fulham fan wiki. He was in matchday squads, but he never came off the bench. I can only assume he dreamed it. He played 266 professional games. Sorry, he has played. He is alive. 266 professional games for MK Dons, Dundee, Oldham, Yeovil. Had 3 years at Barnet playing under Edgar Davids. Of course, Forest Green Rovers, Dover, Newport. He then headed USA stateside to play in the second division for Memphis 901. There it is. Quite exotic. 3 goals in 13 games for Memphis in the year 2020. Playing alongside Jose Baxter, if you remember him, the old Everton lad. So his career's generally hovered between League One and the Conference Premier. Currently, in real life, playing just down the road from us at the New Lawn here, down for Gloucester City in the National League North.
It's a real group mentality in this lineup about pressing the opposition into making mistakes and cashing in on it straight away.
Well, it takes a lot of energy.
He played 21 games in total for England at under 16 level, under 17, and played for England C, but now actually plays for Guyana. 1 goal in 15 games for Guyana, for Keanu Marsh-Brown. And his brother, Ronayne, also plays for Guyana. Not sure if he still does, but he certainly did. And Ronayne Marsh-Brown's career path really is worth a look at. He played for 25 different non-league clubs as a journeyman left back. There are two other Marsh-Brown brothers called Kwai and Kai, who are also professional footballers. They both play for Antigua and Barbuda. Right, concentrate on the game for a bit here. Good old Charles Breakspear. He's not going to let any nonsense go on today. Charlie Cooper getting ready for the kickoff there. Bit of a local derby, this one, of course. South West. Forest Green versus Exeter City. No away goals in the League Two playoffs, I have checked. Oh! An early chance for the visitors. Hits it first time, that looked dangerous. Okay. Yeah, Keanu Marsh-Brown's longest spell was with Forest Green. He went to Wembley twice with us. First was in the losing playoff final, where they... Oh my goodness. Well out. Good stuff there. And then the winner, he scored in the one where we didn't go up into the League Two, and then he played all 90 minutes in the one where they did go up into League Two.
opportunity, really.
And was then ditched for this campaign in real life by Mark Cooper. Sent packing off to Dover Athletic. This version of Mark Cooper, we've kept him on, and he's been pretty good for us. Pace and power down the side. Here he is now. No, taken off him by Moxie. Right, concentrate, Paino. Well in, Charlie.
Nice return pass.
Ah, oh, shit from Kurtovic. Need to get a grip on this game. Fashioned a lot of chances in the first leg. Whoa, it's all Exeter for the first 10 minutes. Now, Keanu Marsh-Brown's favourite player as a kid was Robinho. He feels like he enjoys the game more when the manager gives him freedom to play, as in anywhere along the front, drifting in. So it's something we might try today, is maybe experiment with a front three. Stick Marsh Brown up there, but he's a bit tired. Never mind about that, Paino. Come on, we've got to fucking stop letting him in. Oh, they've scored. Bastards. It was a lovely finish, but I rushed the keeper out. It might have been the wrong choice.
That was perhaps the place where it was impossible to save it. No goalkeeper could have reached that.
No, he didn't move. And yeah, it was just an amazing finish into the top corner. What a goal to get this playoff semi up and running. Keanu Marsh-Brown likes dairy milk chocolate, Haribo and ice cream. His favourite ice creams are strawberry, mint and butter pecan. I bet he pecan believe he might get promoted this year. Forest Green Rovers. Here he is. Oh my gosh. I'm really not on my game here. Just stop thinking about ice cream. Oh, Megs. Well in, Charlie. Now gets go.
Collins. And Cooper. On to the attack now. Looked very good indeed, but the move is broken down. Now Brucht.
It's just all Exeter, isn't it?
Bit of space to go forward into with the ball. You can see what he was trying to do with the ball.
Okay, let's go attacking. See if we're gonna at least test the keeper. Come on. Oh, that's shit. Oh dear, we're just a yard off everything at the moment. Oh my gosh, that's terrible.
And Cooper.
Shit cross from Keanu Marsh-Brown.
Headed pass then, and a shrewd one. Stopped emphatically and just as well. The approach play looks very encouraging.
And that's a poor header from Charlie Cooper. What is going on with Forest Green?
And they cut it out. Cooper. Had to come back into his own half to get hold of possession.
A heavy, heavy touch from Fernandez, and we give possession back and letting them through. Do apologise to anybody watching this. It's painful. We've got to get back into it. Oh dear. Seven shots to none in the first half at the New Lawn. The fans must be absolutely spitting feathers. And again, we just give it back. I give it back. What am I doing? It's the pressure, isn't it? It's the pressure of the... We can feel Wembley beckoning us. And League One. Sorry to skip that replay. Oh man.
It's good play until they got that challenge in. Here they are.
Here's Reece Brown.
Trying to steer it through.
We've hit the post. Oh, I thought that was in. Perhaps should have had a shot with Reece Brown. Right, doing a bit better here. Fernandez with his left. It was not the best, but...
Straight to him, didn't they? Keanu Marsh-Brown. Spread the intentions of the opposition there to make the interception.
I think this will be it.
Cooper.
Well,
I know what the manager will be saying. I know him well. Well, I know at the halftime we'll be going, look, this is
going okay.
To be important 45 minutes of your career. Get yourself into the final.
Do we go with three up top for the first time this season?
Whether these players have got it in them, I don't know. They looked a bit tired coming to the end of that first half.
I don't know if Keanu Marsh-Brown has got the energy in his legs to make it worthwhile putting him up front. And he does claim to like Coldplay, so he's a bit of a softie. Look at this shit. Dear me. Right. Let's give it a go. We can always change it back. Let's see how he goes. At the top in a 4-3-3. Okay. It's a bit stupid having Christian Deutsch out on the wing, isn't it? But then Fernandez is looking pretty tired. Let's give this a look. Although perhaps Fernandez can play out there in a sort of Romelu Lukaku type role. Let's give it a go. We're experimenting.
And he blows for the second half to start. That's good movement forward here.
Offside flag. It's already telling me to bring Marsh-Brown off. Yeah, he's tired. He's tired from the first leg. Should have perhaps rested him for that.
And quick in his movement too to intercept there. played forward. A bit of menace in this attack.
And we're at the wrong end of the pitch again. Reece Brown, I think, is in the middle as well, which is no good for him. Offside again.
The defending team might be in trouble.
No, drawn a foul, Charlie Cooper. But as we know, I am shit with these free kicks. Might just have a shot for a change.
Free kick on target.
Awful.
Throw in to come. Keanu Marsh-Brown.
Come on, little Robinho. 6 foot one Robinho. Christian Deutsch, oh no! I think Keanu's going to have to come off. We'll bring on his protege, Campbell, in a similar role. Tavon Campbell, number 25, here he comes. Well done, Keanu. If he wasn't a footballer, Keanu reckons he'd get into fashion design. So perhaps that's where he's off to now. Oh, Gavin Gunning's on a run. No, he's not. Is that not offside, Charlie Cooper? No. Oh, man. Talk to each other. Oh, we got it. Charlie Cooper has scored a goal which could turn our season around. We could go from relegation, almost rans, to playoff finalists, if not promotion, thanks to my boy, Mark Cooper's son, Charlie Cooper. What a move from Forest Green, from nothing. Two passes, one, two, touch, shoot, and it sneaks in. Oh, Charlie, I could kiss you, mate. You've saved us. Now, I think this formation is doing better. Exeter haven't got in much since we switched to the 4-3-3.
Great news for the manager, because I think he made,
so let's stick with it.
And now they're back on level terms.
And remember, we've got Tavon Campbell's legs to use on the right wing now. Well done, Charlie.
Don't forget, we're dealing with the aggregate score here. 1-1 now. He's on the move all the time and makes lots of these interceptions. Attacking well here. This is Campbell. Here's Brown.
It's a nothing pass from Brown, and we could be, of course, looking at extra time at the New Lawn.
Well, the pressure paying off as an aimless clearance.
Your wife is waiting for you.
Oh, Reece Brown's shot is deflected.
Deflected behind. Clear corner.
Do we bring Kurtovic off for Osborne? Of course we do. Come on, Ozzy. This is your time, mate. Kurtovic has had a great season. On comes the Brummy lad. To take the corner.
Here comes the corner. It's a promising situation. They could have made more of that. Cooper.
Oh, it's a shit pass in the end from Reece Brown.
Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here.
It's a foul from Lee Collins, captain from right back. Not seen much from him today.
Is that just a case of mistiming the tackle?
Yeah, it was a tackle in many ways. it's a poor one.
I feel like it had to be dead. Let's hope it doesn't kick us in the teeth from the free kick. We're still on attacking, remember. 20 minutes to go. Ooh, it's a short one.
Simpson.
Simpson, eh?
Proper tackle, that.
Here's Tavon Campbell. Oh, he's... I fucked it up. Here's Isaiah Osborne, though. Plays it through to Charlie Cooper. Christian Deutsch shoots, saved. And we can't get the corner. Ooh, left footed. Not a great shot. Yeah, Exeter have been very quiet second half.
The manager Alan is making this change here. Substitution will take place.
The last few minutes he seems to be tiring a little, but his goal was certainly well taken and hit the woodwork.
Big ball from Fernandez. Tavon Campbell chases it. And he's won it. Oh, he terribly panicked. It was too good to be true. Great ball from Fernandez, though. Right, we're defending again.
Well, this attack had a bit of menace to it. Nodded back into the middle.
Isaiah Osborne clears up. Here's Rhys Brown. He's a bit tired. Perhaps he can find Campbell. Not so good that time. He's chasing it though. Oi! Hey! Forced a mistake from the keeper. Fernandez! Oh, it's a tame effort. Scott Laird, ever dependable. Here's Tavon Campbell. Oh, and he's bullied off the ball.
So we'll restart with a throw-in.
Rhys Brown's done all right playing in the middle. Here he comes. Oh, poor.
Now Brown. Maybe the counter-attack is on here. Good football between these two. Nice passing.
Ah, oh, can't find the right player. There's Collins. Oh no. Oh, it's poor from Laird. Oh, that's. Oh, I thought that was in. Rhys Brown needs to come off. I think Clements will be a nice steadying influence in the midfield. Got to be. Rhys Brown's run his tits off. Well done, mate. And it looks like we might be going for extra time. Oh, it's a terrible cross ball across the box. And Fernandez is going to have to play a full 120, even though he's knackered. And yes, we've got to play another half an hour, and I'm very scared of penalties. I haven't practiced any, despite knowing that I can't score them. Right, so we've had, nine shots each. Slightly better accuracy than them, but nothing great. All of ours coming from two from outside the box. Right, let's just get on with it. Oh yeah, Fernandez has got nothing left. I think we're going to have to put him in the middle and just leave him in there. Christian Deutsch can go out on the wing.
Extra time, it starts, and the drama, I think, is going to continue here. Simpson. Could be dangerous.
They've scored. No, they haven't. God, I'm scared.
Can he pick somebody out with his pullback? And the goalkeeper across to it.
Fucking hell. Oh, Deutsch, come on, man. Give me a break. Oh, what's that? And we failed to clear it again. Oh, God. What happened there? Please. Fucking hell. Comes off his knee. This keeper, by the way, he's actually... should be in loan. I don't think it's got listed as a player on loan, but he should be on loan from Chelsea, I think.
In goes the corner.
Get it out. Ah, oh, well done, mate. God, that's it, he's saying, get out of here. Friend Rawson is under pressure and he's giving it away. But Cooper. Oh, it's two against two.
Good position. They've worked this attack very well. Into a quite a dangerous position now.
Oh, that's it.
Gavin Gunning.
Oh, fucking hell. Get it out, lads. Right, here we go. Steady.
4 minutes to play for Paddington.
2 minutes of added time.
Some potential in this move.
Oh, Charlie Cooper with the chance to send us to Wembley. Oh, it's awful. What a mess.
Time.
15 minutes to go before our inevitable exit on penalties. Just need to... Oh, look at the state of us. Should we put Ozzy Osbourne forward a bit? Everyone's knackered. Campbell, Clements, Osborne. Yeah, just checking we have used all our subs. We're still on attacking, and I'm not even sure if that's the best. Sometimes we do all right when we're on defensive, you know. Tavon Campbell gives it away from the corner, but we're still on. We're overplaying it now. And it's the substitute. Is it Chris Clements?
Still hasn't decided it.
He's not. He's had a lukewarm season, this guy. But he might have scored the most important goal of the year for Forest Green. The fans go nuts. He can't believe it's happened. Charlie Cooper. Oh, Fernandez with the assist.
Yeah, he sets high standards, this lad, and I think he's just dropped below those.
And it was, not the best shot in the world, but the keeper did it, did the rest for him. Well done, lads. Right, we're going defensive. One goal in the League Two playoffs. Yeah, I think he must have scored in the regular season. We're going ultra defensive. Fuck it. These minutes will fly by. And it's all going to be about... Oh.
And it's Wilson. We're coming towards the end. Narrow lead here. Still a possibility of an equaliser and penalties. 5 minutes to go. That will be a throw.
5 minutes. There's Charlie Cooper with his hands clasped calmly behind his back.
Now Wilson. It's good movement forward here. Simpson. He can lay it off to the supporting player. Cleared it well.
That's it. The ball's going in the right direction, away from our net. Nailsworth Facebook update on its way. Moss Wheeler. Exeter in. Oh, it's a save. Cooper can't prevent the corner. Up comes the Exeter keeper. Park the bus. If they score, it's penalties. Come on, lads, put us out of our misery. Here comes the keeper.
Put the corner in the middle.
Blow the whistle, ref. Blow the whistle, ref. Gunning with the clearance. And Forest Green are on their way to Wembley. Christian Deutsch didn't have the best of games. Missed a couple of chances. Pablo Fernandez was a big part of the attack. Big presence up front, even when he had to play on the wing. Keanu Marsh-Brown, no, was poor. Sorry, mate. But it was Charlie Cooper and Chris Clements who fire us into the playoff final. Well done, gents. So, what have we got? Facebook, looking at the Nailsworth community Facebook page, so you don't have to. Jacqueline asks, does anyone know what the loud buzzing noise is? And then follows it up with, is it a helicopter? Cammy says, hornet on my windowsill in Woodchester. Joe suggests Martians. Jacqueline finishes by saying it stopped now, but went on for a long time. Sounded like a chainsaw. Well, the mystery remains unsolved. All I've got to say is like, comment or subscribe. Email naphabit@gmail.com and we will respond. Thanks for watching. See you at Wembley. Good night.